Show respect to our students who have worked so hard. We do have Mrs. Shally again as our guest pianist, and then I'll turn it over to Mrs. McMillan for the show. Thank you for being here.
Well, Mr. Haas may be able to talk loud enough without these on, but my kids sure won't.
Song introductions when our audience has the song titles listed right there in their program seems a little bit redundant, doesn't it?
Well, Will, not really. In the song introduction, we can explain a little bit about the music so hopefully the song will make sense and have meaning for the audience. Kind of like when we talk about the song in class and we all go, oh, now I get it.
Like our first song, Yonder Come Day, which comes from the Georgia Sea Islands.
Where are the Georgia Sea Islands? I've never heard of them before.
These lush plantation lands dot the coastline of Georgia and the Carolinas on the eastern seaboard of the United States. They were the first stop for many American slave ships making their way to the North American mainland.
Yes, the song Yonder Come Day is based on a traditional Georgia Sea Island spiritual, or song, sung by slaves. We will sing it a cappella, which just as the slaves would have sung it.
Generational and ideological boundaries within, with and for children, raising awareness and funds for programs and music worldwide.
In the project notes, Mr. Tavlis writes, "It seems to me now that we are all struggling with an increasing amount of negative influences in the lives of children. In order for a child to feel strength and to believe in themselves, it must come from within. When I close my eyes, then I can see and I am not afraid."
Children's Choir, the Columbus Children's Choir, and on the staff of Butler University.
In 2005, Mrs. Dwyer arranged this song and dedicated it to the Indianapolis Children's Choir.
Thank you.
Here's a perfect example of why these introductions are important. Our next song is in a foreign language.
Kyrie Eis is a traditional Latin text which means Lord have mercy. The A section of the pieces are in Latin, and the B section is in English. There are many, many arrangements of the Kyrie text, but ours happens to be by Christy Carey Miller in one of the choir's favorite pieces.
So Thank you.
give one more round of applause to our students. Thank you, Mrs. Shalley. We truly appreciate your assistance. And one more round of applause for our choral director for the sixth grade, Mrs. McMillan. I'd like to thank RTC4 for being here and doing everything they do for not just only Rochester Community Schools, but our community in general. We're pretty blessed as a small community to have our own TV station that does that for us, so I truly appreciate them being here. We appreciate your support for your students, and at this time, we'd welcome you to stay out in the area to take pictures and socialize, and we thank you for being here. Dr. Terry at this time for the concert. Thank you.
Before we begin, and I forget, I'd like to thank Mrs. McMillan for playing all the songs tonight. I'm playing two of them, but it's okay.
Is gift for writing for developing voices is exemplified through this driving original based on the biblical story of Elijah. The music is filled with articulations such as staccatos, tenuetos, accents, and sorspondos, resulting in a lively, expressive performance.
Thank you.
Recording of his bass jumbo. The text translates, "Hello, hello sir, how are you? I'm very fine. The visitors are welcome to Kenya. It's a nice country, a country of wonders, of peace. Don't worry, everyone is welcome. Don't worry, no one is sir."
Jumbo, Jumbo Kwana, habari gani, mzuri sana, wageni, mwakaribishwa, Kenya yetu, hakuna matata.
Thank you.
sana Wageni nakaribishwa Kenya yetu hakuna mata.
American traditional folk song, allowing the young man and young woman to argue and tease each other through the give and take of the lyrics and melodic phrases. It's simple and smart with a crisp percussive piano accompaniment and great entertainment value.
Concert in May.